Hello guys, so very interesting subject today. Supermodels and their body types. The term supermodel appeared, I think, in the 80s, right? In the end of the 80s and in the 90s. So it was a very certain time. See, before the profession as a model, that woman wasn't a star. That woman wasn't a celebrity. That woman wasn't an authority. People didn't know much about the models. The models were just women who demonstrating some clothes for other people. So people didn't quite remember their faces. People didn't quite remember who they were. They didn't know their names very often. And then something happened, probably because of the TV, MTV, because of the runway shows. They started to show it on TV a lot. And something happened. That was that era when top models, supermodels, they became very well known. They became like celebrities. They started playing in the movies. They started playing in music videos of famous bands. They started getting roles in advertisements. They started having a lot of money. They became very rich. Cindy Crawford, Claudia Schiffer, Naomi Campbell, all those beautiful and tall women. If you remember the models before, they were slightly different, right? In the 50s and the 40s, we could find ladies that were not probably that tall. They had some figure, they had maybe hourglass figure, so they would demonstrate in different kinds of clothes. They just had different kinds of the bodies. Now, in the 60s, it was a pretty big revolution, right? Twiggy became very popular, but she also wasn't that kind as the supermodels. And then it was 70s and 80s, and somehow it led us to those very tall, the very specific bodies that had to be approved for the runway shows and for being models. Couldn't be like lower than this height. They had to have special figure. They had to be very thin. If they were slightly overweight, they didn't take them. So you had to have a very certain body structure and body type to actually have this profession. So what we're gonna talk about today, as you know, I have pretty huge David Kibbe body types series on this channel. If you're interested, I'm gonna leave the link down below on my Kibbe playlist. Kibbe has five main body types. It's dramatic, tall and pretty straight. Romantic is the opposite, like small, soft, rounded, like Marilyn Monroe. Classic, like Grace Kelly. Everything is mixed together, so everything is very moderate and very proportionate. And then we have natural. They're slightly squarish in bones. And we have gamines. Gamines are more like teenage girls. They look slightly childish and they're like tomboys a little bit. So overall it's 13 body types because most of them have their softer and sharper version. When David Kibbe wrote his book Metamorphosis, then later he was typing some celebrities, some models, and he has so-called official David Kibbe celebrities list, where he places this or that celebrity into a certain category, one of 13 categories. Most of supermodels, as David Kibbe says, is flamboyant natural type, meaning it's a mixture of natural and dramatic. So they're naturals, they have slightly squarish bones, blunt bones, not sharp, not round, but blunt bones, but they are pretty elongated looking. So proportionately, when we look at them, we perceive them as more on a taller side, like we perceive their vertical line. They're slightly wider here on top, can be. Even if they have some figure or they are absolutely straight, we don't perceive them as curvy women. We normally perceive them as pretty tall or pretty on a taller side, having long vertical line, pretty squarish shoulders here, pretty blunt bones, pretty strong facial bones, pretty strong facial features. They can look slightly on a muscular side, especially if they're workout very much. Your body type is not changing if you're gaining weight or you're losing weight. Pretty often you can notice that they have wider rib cage or wider chest area, or if their chest area is not as wide, for example, Candice Swanepoel, she's also flamboyant natural. She's also elongated and she's slightly muscular. Her bones are on the stronger side. She has square shoulders and she has pretty wide shoulders. And even though her ribcage is slightly on a narrower side, it's just her personal feature. But the overall vibe, the overall yin and yang balance is, of course, flamboyant natural. It's closest, she's closest to flamboyant naturals. They don't have to look exactly like each other, right? But they just do have some similarities. And that's what we can actually see. Some people might say that Candice Swanepoel, she's more like a soft natural probably. She looks like softer and stuff, but big blue eyes, full lips, blonde hair, slight some cheeks on her face. some pretty small waist should not confuse you. The actual bone structure is pure flamboyant natural that she has. And if we compare, if we see her standing with other people, for example, here she's standing with her colleagues, flamboyant natural, so you can see that they have pretty similar structure, pretty similar silhouette. Gigi Hadid, she is flamboyant natural too. She has some figure, yes, but we still don't perceive her as curvy woman. Imagine Sophia Loren, imagine Monica Bellucci. Those ones we perceive as more curvy than sporty and pretty muscular. And soft dramatic, they are called soft dramatic women. We perceive more as a curvy woman. And Gigi Hadid, she's more on a squarish side. She's pretty tall, she's elongated, and she has square, blunt bones. Healthy and slightly muscular body structure with pretty blunt bones and pretty squarish shoulders. Now let's shift our attention to models or supermodels that are not flamboyant natural. And let's start with dramatic supermodels. Yes, there are quite a few dramatic supermodels. Linda Evangelista. She is a dramatic supermodel. Why is she dramatic? Because dramatics have thinner bones. Normally they have thinner shoulders. Their shoulders are not as wide and they are less on the muscular side. They look slightly alien. Their facial features are slightly more chiseled and their facial bones can be thinner. They are more elongated looking and we don't see that width necessarily on the top here. So they're sharper looking and this is what's happening. And Linda Evangelista, she has that sharper bones. More modern dramatic model is Feifei Sun. Amazing, very beautiful model. She's also on an elongated side, but we don't perceive her on more muscular and on wider side. We perceive her as on the narrower side. She has narrower facial bones, narrower facial features. She has narrower bone structure. Her legs, her shoulders are narrower too. So she's slightly closer to a dramatic side rather than to a flamboyant natural side. Flamboyant naturals have kind of like a certain vibe in them too. Olivia Culpo, she's another dramatic. Even though she doesn't look like extremely elongated for me like other people, I think she's a model, right? Correct me if I'm wrong. She's maybe an actress too, but as I know, she was modeling too. So Olivia Culpo, as far as she's very sharp and she consists of sharp angles, she's very much on the young side. She is very square. She has very prominent, squarish and sharp facial features. She has very sharp jawline, very sharp chin, pretty sharp lips, pretty sharp eyes, sharp nose. She has square shoulders, pretty sharp shoulders. She has pretty squarish figure, even though, yes, she has difference between her waist, chest area and hips, but she consists of more straight lines and she's not that lush and voluptuous. She doesn't have that fleshy figure. So she's more on the dry side and she's pretty angular and very sharp. And she does look slightly elongated. So she is a dramatic model. And somewhere in internet I saw that David Kibbe put Kate Moss as a dramatic maybe. He said maybe as a she is a dramatic. I think yeah, it's very possible that she's a dramatic, so I can see that because she has pretty chiseled bone structure on her face. She has very defined cheekbones, very sharp lips, thin, pretty sharp nose, small, sharp eyes. She is not as probably wide as and as blunt as flamboyant naturals. So she's very possibly dramatic for me. Let me know in the comments what you think, guys. Soft dramatic. Soft dramatic is dramatic with some soft figure, lush and voluptuous. So Tyra Banks, she is in David Kibbe's list as a supermodel soft dramatic, not flamboyant natural. She doesn't have enough width, for example, here on top, she doesn't have enough width. She doesn't have enough musculature. She is more prominent in terms of a figure here. You can check her knees, her fleshy upper arms and fleshy thighs, her facial bones. She has pretty sharp bone structure, but on top of the sharp bone structure, she has some flesh and that figure. And we do perceive her as more curvy woman. So Tyra Banks is in David Kibbe's list is soft dramatic. Among so many flamboyant naturals, we have one natural, and this is Cara Delevingne. And the reason why I think he put her in natural category, and as you know, guys, right now, he removed those three pure categories like gamines, naturals and classics. He only has now a sharper version or softer version because he says they're kind of those pure balance balanced bodies don't exist. I stick to the book for now. I like it. I would like to look at this from this viewpoint that they do exist. So I do understand why back then he put Cara Delevingne into natural category, because she doesn't look as elongated. She looks more like a rectangular. Her facial bones are not also as prominent as elongated. She has blunt bones for sure. She's slightly squarish for sure. But if we place her with other models, for example, or we just look at her by herself, she doesn't look as elongated, as strong. So her width slightly is compensating the height and the long vertical line. She's also not super tall, not as I know. And if you Google their height, it's very often that they lie about their height. They sometimes put several centimeters more, both for models and for actresses. So it's pretty hard to tell what exactly her height is. I'm gonna leave here what Google says about that. But just in general, just look at that from that viewpoint. She doesn't look quite super elongated. So she's slightly cuter, shorter facial features too. Now we have two soft naturals. First one is Leticia Casta, also one of supermodels. But if you look at her, first of all, she doesn't have that vertical line. We don't perceive her as extremely tall. Sometimes the person is built this way, so the proportion sometimes of their head to the rest of the body, or just in general, the proportions of the torso, legs comparing to the torso, torso comparing to the head, head comparing to the shoulders and all that thing. So you kind of can't predict their bone structure. So you kind of can predict their size sometimes, but sometimes you can't. Leticia Casta is 167 centimeters long as per Google. Again, I'm not sure if it's true or not, but still not very high for supermodels, right? And 5'6". So basically she wasn't that tall, but it's not the point. It's more important of how she looked like. Blunt bones for sure, slightly squarish for sure, but not very elongated and slightly soft, soft flesh. So that gives us soft natural. She's more to the soft natural category than flamboyant natural. Yes, she has slightly squarish shoulders too, but that's what many soft naturals do have. But on top of that, she has very soft facial features too, which is adding to that whole picture. Now, I also seen in official David Kibbe's list that Heidi Klum, she's soft natural. Maybe they already retyped her, I'm not sure. But I also could see why they put her in soft natural category, because again, of the more delicate bone structure on her face. Her height is 1.75 meters or 5'9", slightly on a taller side. But again, if we look at her separately from everyone, if we look at her, she doesn't look quite elongated. She looks slightly more on a square side, on a rectangular side. She does have blunt bones for sure. She does have slightly squarish shoulders, slightly more powerful here on the top part, and slightly muscular, slightly flat. But at the same time, her bone structure on her face looks slightly more delicate, and also her bone structure in general looks a little bit more delicate. I can see why he put her in soft natural category. We have one dramatic classic among modern models, and this is Lily Eldridge. If you've seen many of my videos actually about dramatic classic versus other types and stuff, I already was talking about this, and I was showing so many pictures of her comparing to other models. So we could see how proportionately she is slightly different. She's much more balanced. She's very proportionate in terms of the overall symmetry of the human body. And she's also not the tallest of them. She's not super tall. And even if we compare her to other flamboyant naturals that are pretty same height with her, she still has a slightly different proportions. The size of her head comparing to her shoulders, the size of her shoulders comparing to her torso, torso comparing to the legs, legs comparing to the head, and so on. So this is the overall combination of different parts of the body that create that proportionate and very symmetrical look of the body. So she is more on a dramatic classic side. Classic is moderate in everything. Classics don't look tall or small, they look pretty average, and she's also not of the tallest ones of them. So as her overall structure of the body, it does look like dramatic classic. This is basically classic with some dramatic undercurrent in her. She has some angularity in her bones, just slightly more powerful bone structure for face or for body, but still she's symmetrical. And flamboyant naturals and naturals, they are not symmetrical, so they have this asymmetry in their body and slight disproportion. And last but not least, we have two flamboyant gamines. And actually one flamboyant gamine, you are very familiar with her, it's Twiggy. Twiggy is a 60s model. I don't know if I can call her supermodel. Supermodel started a bit later. But Twiggy is a great example of flamboyant gamine. If we measure her in centimeters, she could probably be the same height as those other models. However, she did look smaller. She did look more like a tomboy rather than like a tall and healthy woman kind of a thing, right? So her top part here, it was slightly angular, slightly squarish, but it wasn't broad. She wasn't broad here on top. She wasn't broad in general. She was broadly angular, slightly broad, slightly angular. She had more childish facial features, slightly broad, again, slightly broad and angular, but not wide or prominent. She was quite delicate. She was much more delicate comparing her to other models. So that's why proportionately she was more flamboyant gamine. And another flamboyant gamine that I just recently found out about, and she is, I'm not sure that she's an official David Kibbe's list, maybe somebody else typed her, but I quite agree with that Emily Ratajkowski, she is also a flamboyant gamine. She has a flamboyant gamine body structure. She has flamboyant gamine frame. She's 1 meter 66 centimeters, 5'5", according to Google, again, so we don't know for sure, but she's quite broadly angled. She has slightly squarish shoulders, and she has quite straight figure, even though she has pretty voluptuous front part here. But still, she has pretty narrow figure and pretty narrow and pretty straightish outline. She's just pretty small body type. She doesn't look large, and her bone structure is closer to that Audrey Hepburn, Twiggy, and Penelope Cruz vibe. All right, I hope that was interesting. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you very soon. Bye-bye. Subscribe on my Pinterest for 13 boards as an inspiration for the body types. Also, you can subscribe on my Instagram. All the links I'm gonna leave down below. Also, you can become my sponsor or subscribe on my Patreon for some exclusive videos, some early access to these videos, and just if you want to support me and my channel. Thank you so much, guys, and I'll see you very soon. Bye-bye.